We are here live at the Mall of Millennia, and I'm about to get one of my first birthday presents. And it is the one, the only, Lauren Brooke Thompson.
Oh, I wish I brought my present for you.
You are all that I need for a birthday present. When the producers of the show came to me and said, we want to do a birthday special, give us a list of names that you'd like as your guests. I put a V in front of your name, though, by the way, because I feel that's the Lauren Brooke Thompson was top on the list.
Yes. Sweet. Cool. I'm here.
Well, so what's been going on with you since last that we spoke?
Just working, honestly. We've got between TNA and the Golf Channel and College Sports Minute, it's been pretty busy, but it's been fun. A lot of fun stuff going on with TNA. If anyone's been watching, I've been running out there in the ring quite a bit, so we'll see what's coming on.
I actually have a feeling, I know you keep telling me no, but I have a feeling that sooner than later, our very own Lauren will be in a mixed tag team match.
No wrestling for me. That's like the top question that I get with any radio thing or anything. Just people, you know, asking me that on the side of the ring. But I think I'm going to stick with backstage interviewer. It's just more me. I don't really think I'm bred to be a wrestler here. So I'm going to stick with what's safe.
Are you sure?
Pretty sure. I'm 99.9% sure.
I think your guns are a little bit bigger since last time we spoke.
Yeah, I've been working out. Just kidding. God, I wish. You know that I can't even flex my left arm? Like I can flex my right arm for sure, but I cannot even flex my left arm. Even when I try, it's like I'm just not even capable of doing it. I really don't know. And don't ask how I figured it out either. People will be like, oh, well, let me feel your arm. I'm like, no, you have to feel my right arm because I can't flex my left arm. And that's been my answer since third grade. It's pretty pathetic.
That's pretty awesome. That's not pathetic. Yeah, we just got a good story out of you. So, well, TNA's been doing great rating-wise, and I'm sure a lot of that is due to your backstage interviewing, but honestly, you guys have been doing great lately, so that's got to be a good feeling. Morale's got to be very high around the company.
Ratings, honestly, the last few shows, it's been the top ratings that we've had, so that's huge for everyone, whether they're in the office in Nashville or, you know, if they're in the ring, so that's really, really cool for us, and we've got a lot of exciting things going on. We've got Slammiversary coming up. We're going to be in Detroit, so it'll be cool.
Yeah, you'll be in the Palace of Auburn Hills, so that's a big house. It'll be interesting for you guys. I'm sure everybody's looking really forward to that.
Yes, and I've got a bunch of friends coming that were, some of them not even in the area, but they were like 2 hours away, so they're driving in. They're going to see it, so we're hoping to pack that place out. It'll be really cool.
Oh, very cool. That's awesome. Now, over to the Golf Channel.
Okay.
You got a lot of fun stuff over there. I told you I now have a second favorite show, and that's the one where they're trying to teach Charles Barkley how to swing. But that's my second favorite show behind Top 10, which you host. So go ahead and tell us a little bit about that.
Well, we were kind of on a pause there, and we were doing reruns for a little bit. But we just taped last June, and we've got a bunch of really cool stuff coming up as far as Tiger Woods celebrations and things along those lines. So really, really fun footage coming up on Top 10. Tuesdays at 9, if you didn't know, I'm going to go ahead and just shamelessly self-promote the show. Right. And we've got, I can't really say exactly what it is right now. They specifically told me not to talk about it, but I'm going to another country to start another show with Golf Channel, so stay tuned.
Oh, well, that's very awesome. And you know, it's well-deserved. You do a great job at everything you do. I really do have to say that. And speaking of great jobs, there is something that, and actually Donnie and I have talked about this, because I said, I wonder if like Lauren just wakes up in the morning and life is that easy for her. You have had two modeling shoots that I've seen recently.
Okay.
One was, I believe, in April with HC Orlando, and the other was in May with Nick Suarez. And your photos came out absolutely amazing.
Thank you.
Are these things, and I mean this as a compliment, are these things easy for you, or are they a lot of hard work?
No, photo shoots especially, and my God, I wish I could show you guys the unfinished version of these pictures, because they are totally different. Like, I always say they whiten, tighten, and tan. They whiten your teeth, they tighten up your stomach and your arms and everything, and then they tan you up. So, obviously, the finished product is much different. But those guys, the guys from HC Orlando, are friends with Nick Suarez, and Nick is 18 years old. He's a really good photographer. I don't want to plug him too much here. I don't know what all I can say, but he's amazing. And when I met him, I remember being like, how old are you? And like, your work is that developed. It's really amazing for photography. So thanks for noticing.
What is the line?
The line to cross the line? I knew it. I knew he was going to do this. See, that line especially.
Is it the Mason-Dixon line?
I dude, I have no idea even where the line is, but it'll come up in interviews every once in a while, and people don't even mean to say, you just crossed the line, and then we all kind of, like, laugh, and then you continue the interview. So it's really funny, because that's just a very typical thing to say, and we say it all the time, and it just makes us laugh when it's not intentional.
And I swear this is the last TNA thing I'm going to ask. I just want it on record. Okay. Please, I'm hoping that you have the empowerment to do something about this. Samoa Joe's pajamas.
Oh my god, they're so bad. Joe is one of those guys right now.
Does he hate him? Tell me.
I don't even know. I haven't even heard like his view on what he thinks about the pajamas, but I don't know, man. And like the face tattoo, like everything's just kind of weird with that guy right now. So we're gonna have to see where that goes.
The pajamas gotta go. I wasn't a fan of his old tights, but I am now.
Yeah, his tight little uniform. Yeah, absolutely. Everyone thought it would be an improvement, and I think they want it back. I think they're begging.
Here's a fun little thing, and that I'm going to ask you, because we always have fun with Lauren. Do you have any odd habits? And for instance, I'll set this for you. And I didn't realize this until like a couple months ago, that I do this every single time I get in an elevator. I check the expiration date.
Of the license?
Yeah, of the license.
Yeah.
And I realize that's like an odd habit. So are there any odd habits that you have, Lauren?
I have so many, and I can't even think of them right now, but I've had people point them out. One thing that's so weird that I do that's kind of like just odd, but when I sit down at restaurants, the first thing I do is I like straighten out my forks and knives and everything, and I like put it even. That's really odd. I know, and he's doing this right now, but she's crazy. But no, that's weird. And then I have so many things.
Is that weird or is that obsessive?
Little obsessive compulsive with that, but not with anything else. That's the thing. Everyone else is like, are you a neat freak? Are you this? Are you that? Because that's something people do when they're neat freaks, and I'm really not. So it's just that one thing, I guess. Little obsessive compulsive.
That's crazy. Not crazy. It's just a little thing. So usually I start off the interview with this, but I held it back till now. And plus, I know he's still alive, so it's okay for me to ask. How's Optimus Prime?
Oh, Optimus Prime is good. She's little. My hamster, of course, if you didn't see the first interview. She's about this big, and she's gray and white, and she's just trucking, man. I mean, I've had her like 2 years now, and I'm about to move in a couple months, so hopefully she can make it through the move.
She's about near the end of her rope, huh?
Yeah, she's a feeble kitten, so we'll see if she can make it. I hope she can.
I'll keep a roll of toilet paper on the side for you.
You can't beat it. Hamsters are awesome.
What else now is on the horizon for you, Lauren? What's next? It seems like, I don't know if you remember the show in Living Color, but there was a section, the segment where they had the Jamaicans with, I think it was Keenan Ivory Wayans and Damon Wayans, and they always had a new job. They had like 8 jobs. That's pretty much you. You've got TNA, you've got
really
Golf Channel.
Contracts right now, so nothing really too crazy. I've got the new thing coming up with Golf Channel, and I'll hopefully fill you guys in on that a few months from now, because we're taping it, and it's kind of a secret, so I'll fill you in later.
Well, Lauren, again, thank you so much. I can't really, honestly, you've been so wonderful to us all the time. I can't say it enough. And I chose this setting outside because there were no doorways, and I know I always like to flatter you. And you always say, well, you always tell me if I keep it up, your head's not going to be able to get through the door. So I figured, well, let's do away with the doors.
You're so complimentary.
Yeah, so, but thank you, Lauren. We appreciate it. The official, laurenbrooke.com.
Yep.
If you want any other Lauren Brooke news, TNA's Thursday night, 9 o'clock, yeah. Cross the Line, top 10 on the Golf Channel, 9 o'clock Tuesday nights, yeah. And NCAA
College Sports Minute. That's on Hulu.com, but that's not on, it's just on Hulu. If you search College Sports Minute in your Google site, it'll pop right up.
Ron John's Surfboards, which Donnie just figured out is you. So thrilled. You can catch those on any local highway.
Yeah, they're coming down kind of soon because they've been up for a while, but they've been up since 2005. But yeah. They're there right now, so that's what counts.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, this is the Lauren Brooke Thompson. See you later.